Would you like a better way of recording receiving the final retainage payment? This method shown in this video is a better way because it gives you the ability to actually bill the client for the outstanding remaining retainage. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. If you use this better method for receiving withheld retainage, then you must make a retainage payment item and put that item on the list of products and services. Now, the retainage payment item is part of method number 2, and it gives you more of what you need as a QuickBooks Online user. It only takes a moment to set up, and again, it allows you to bill the client specifically for the last retention payment and the total amount outstanding. It actually adds the invoice for the last retention payment to the client's overall balance, and that will show in the customer detailed records. So how do we set it up? We have to go to the list of products and services and create an item called final retention payment. We make it a service type of item and we connect it to the retention receivable account. So in the top right, we click the cog wheel and we go to lists, products and services. And in the top right, we click new and we choose service. Now the name can be final retainage payment. And of course, the account that it is connected to will be the retainage receivable account, which is a current asset up here, retention receivable. That was the account that increased when we recorded the actual retention decreasing the invoices. So that is the very same account that we will put the final item in to wipe out the balance. So we click save and close, and now we have it right here on the list. And now we're ready to bill Kirschbaum for the Southwood Roads Jobs retention final payment. What will happen in the trial balance at the moment we send the bill for the final outstanding remainder of the retention? Well, here in the trial balance, retention receivable actually goes down because you no longer will receive retention, or it's no longer indicated as owed as retention. Normal accounts receivable will go up. So it basically takes the balance of what's owed for retention and moves it over to the normal accounts receivable balance, and that's part of the process of sending it on an invoice. And of course, the client's actual balance in the client detailed records will also increase when using this method. So let's imagine on April 30, 2022, we billed Kirschbaum for the remaining retention of the Southwoods Road job. And how do we know that the amount that we should bill is $135? Well, if we actually open up the trial balance, you can see that retention receivable in total is $135. And if we double click, you can see why is it $135? Because even though Brown Company was previously billed for their retention, Brown Company actually paid their retention, and you can see it in the account. But you see, Kirschbaum had these two invoices for both $90 and $45 that were placed on invoices that lowered the invoice for this retention. So it's really billing them for these two in order to get paid for what was withheld from those invoices. So you can see invoice number 9 was, or 1009 was $45. Invoice 1010 was $90. So the total amount that we're billing for Kirschbaum for the outstanding retention is $135. So when we bill Kirschbaum, what will happen in the trial balance? Well, we're billing for all the remaining retention for all clients because Kirschbaum is the only one left. So retention receivable will become zero. But if retention receivable becomes zero, where does the money go? The money increases accounts receivable, and accounts receivable increases to $15,673. And then we will have the retention in the details of the client's records, as well as wiping it out of the trial balance. From the top left, we click New, Invoice. We advance the date to April 30th of 2022. The job is Kirschbaum Southwoods Road. Now, notice we still have this remaining estimate here, but that's not really part of our example. So we're not really going to pay attention to that. We're going to choose the final retention payment, and the amount that we're going to put is the amount that's outstanding, $135. Now we click Save and Close. And don't worry about the number, just click yes. Okay, good. Now when we click reports and we go to the trial balance, the results are exactly as what we expected. Retention receivable is now down to zero because we have billed everyone. And accounts receivable has increased by the amount of retention that we just billed and therefore made part of normal accounts receivable. But most importantly, let's look at the customer reports, because the previous retention did not show on the customer reports, but now this invoice will. So if we click reports and we go to customer balance detail, or in this case, transaction list by customer, we can go down to the Kirschbaum job and we can see that this invoice is now part of the detailed records of the client. You can learn everything you need in QuickBooks regarding contractor features by watching the full playlist that this video is a part of. You can just click the link in the comment field or under the first paragraph in the description field, and there's also links in the top right of the video as it plays.